Hi friends, welcome to Thinkers IAS. Hope this crash course is being very helpful for you all. The information provided in this crash course is to the point and sufficient for Prelims 2020. So, please download the PDF. Link is provided in the description box below. Okay, let's begin with today's topic. Now, let us learn about IPCC, that is Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. It is the United Nations body for assessing the science related to climate change. It does not produce scientific research. It only reviews all the research related to climate change. This is very important. Its headquarters is in Gland, Switzerland. It was established by UNEP and WMO in 1988 to provide policy makers with regular scientific assessments concerning climate change. India is also a member. Till date, it has released 5 publications, 5 assessment reports, and will publish 6th assessment report AR6 in 2021 or 22. IPCC reports. Recently, IPCC released its 2 special reports, that is special report on the ocean and cryosphere in a changing climate, that is SROCC, special report on climate change in land, that is SRCCL. IPCC has received Nobel Peace Prize in 2007. Okay, let's move on to ocean deoxygenation. Report titled Ocean Deoxygenation, Everyone's Problem was released by the International Union for Conservation of Nature, that is IUCN. Now, let us see what is ocean deoxygenation. It simply means loss of oxygen from the oceans. The ocean loses oxygen throughout the whole water column at the surface due to the outgassing of oxygen to the atmosphere. In deeper columns, due to the respiration of aerobic organisms and oxidation of reduced chemical species. But deoxygenation process is increasing at an alarming rate. This is due to various causes. These causes are climate change and global warming. This is because warmer ocean water holds less oxygen and is more buoyant than cooler water, resulting in reduced mixing of oxygenated water near the surface with deeper waters. These reasons are important from prelims point of view. Warmer water raises oxygen demand from living organisms, which in turn increases the metabolic rates. Enhanced release of methane from sediments and subsequent aerobic respiration of methane to CO2. Nutrient pollution, that is eutrophication. So, these are the 5 reasons, that is climate change, warm water, release of methane from sediments and eutrophication. Now, let us learn about IUCN. IUCN is an international organization working in the field of nature conservation and sustainable use of natural resources. This was established in 1948. It was previously called the International Union for the Protection of Nature from 1948 to 1956. It is one of the oldest environmental organizations in the world. This is very important, that is IUCN does not itself aim to mobilize the public in support of nature conservation like Greenpeace and other NGOs. Instead, it tries to influence the actions of governments, business and other stakeholders by providing information and advice and through building partnerships. It compiles and publishes the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. It has membership of over 1400 governmental and non-governmental organizations. Moving on to Global Climate Risk Index 2020. It was released by international environmental think tank German Watch. In this index, India's rank has worsened from 14th spot in 2017 to 5th most vulnerable country to climate change in 2018. You can see the list of the countries in this on the screen. Climate Change Performance Index 2020. It is published by German Watch, Climate Action Network International and the New Climate Institute. The index covers 57 countries and the European Union. Now let us look at India's ranks. GHG emissions on 11, renewable energy on 26, energy use on 9 and climate policy on 15. If we look at the global rankings, top 3 positions are not filled as none of the countries assessed is already on a path compatible with Paris climate targets. 4th rank is Sweden and 5th is Denmark. Interestingly, only 2 G20 countries are in top 10, UK on 7th and India on 9th rank. Remaining G20 countries are in worst category. USA for the first time has replaced Saudi Arabia as the worst performing country. India improved ranking from 11th position to 9th position, which shows India is making efforts in fighting global warming and climate change. Now let us look into Samir app. It is a mobile application released by CPCB for citizens to know about air quality of their cities. It provides hourly updates on the National Air Quality Index, that is AQI. It is developed by the Central Pollution Control Bureau, that is CPCB, which provides information on air quality for more than 100 cities across the country. The app represents the listed cities in a color-coded format based on their air quality index levels. The app can also be used to file or track complaints related to garbage dumping, road dust, vehicular emissions, or other pollution issues in a particular area. Now let us look into Taj Trapezium Zone, that is TTZ. We all know that Taj Mahal is in danger due to air pollution. Taj Trapezium Zone was created to protect the structure from polluting industries. But recently, Supreme Court lifted the ban on construction, industrial activities and felling of trees in the Taj Trapezium Zone. Taj Trapezium Zone is a defined area of 10,400 square kilometer around Taj Mahal to protect the monument from pollution where no polluting industries are set up. It is an eco-sensitive area having 3 World Heritage sites, namely Taj Mahal, Agra Fort and Fatehpur Sikri. Moving on to green crackers. Normal crackers during Deepavali creates air pollution. So, Central Research Institute, that is CSIRNEERI, developed green firecrackers. It is named as SWAS, STAR and SAFAL, that is SWAS, STAR and SAFAL. The green crackers are named as Safe Water Releaser, that is SWAS, Safe Thermite Cracker, that is STAR, and Safe Minimal Aluminium, that is SAFAL, with 30% reduction in particulate matter on an average using potassium nitrate, that is KNO3, as oxidant. Here, thermite is a pyrotechnic composition of metal powder and metal oxide. When ignited by heat, thermite undergoes an exothermic reduction oxidation reaction. It creates heat and high temperature used in crackers. Mechanism includes releases water vapor due to the reduce in the dust. Green logo as well as a quick response QR coding system has been developed for differentiation of green crackers from conventional crackers. They are cheap as well. Please note, crackers are regulated under Petroleum and Explosive Safety Organization, that is PESO. Please refer this to know about the battle for good air. That's it for today. Please subscribe to our channel for more updates on the crash courses, and we are coming up with many other crash courses. Also, please download the PDF and refer them for the revisions of Prelims 2020. This is a very useful PDF. Also, share it with your friends. Thank you so much.